When the pandemic hit, the world masked up, and teen scientist Julie Sage saw need and opportunity.
With the pandemic, there was a lot of accessibility, shortage issues, and there was just a whole bunch of problems because we weren't prepared for it at all.
The Nashua North High School junior had a plan: invent her own face mask, addressing all the critical issues, efficacy, function, comfort, inclusion, even fashion. Her design was a semi-finalist in the XPRIZE Next Gen Mask Challenge, a global competition with a $1 million prize purse. 992 teams entered from 76 countries. Julie's mask made the top 10.
I was crying. Me and my dad were both like hugging each other and crying.
Her mask is made of silicone.
I am using silicone because silicone is a cooler material compared to a lot of other materials. Also, clearness, of course, because of reading lips, seeing faces, everything like that.
Another feature includes a patent-pending design for an inflatable pump valve seal system.
It really gets right close to the face and doesn't hurt the face, but still gets a perfect seal.
The mask can be customized, lengthened to cover beards, tailored to accommodate hijab, and other head coverings, and styled for individual fashion.
It can be different colors, but also you can have different designs and patterns printed onto it, so it can still be fashionable while still wearing it.
Just 17 years old, Julie is a seasoned inventor. In eighth grade, she designed a portable water filtration and distillation system recognized by the 3M company. And NASA carried her experiments into space, accomplishments she shares on her science YouTube channel, 7 Sage Labs.
One was launched on the NASA sounding rocket, and one was also launched on the NASA high altitude balloon.
3, 2, 1, 0, plus one.
It's this great euphoric feeling because it's like, I am doing real science. I am a real scientist, and I am watching the work that I did go into space.
Supernova style.
Julie's social media presence feeds her desire to teach.
This is going to be a super big rocket, and I'm really excited.
She reaches out through YouTube to pique interest in science, technology, engineering, and math.
Science always seemed so cool to me because you could study so many different things, and there was parts of it that was like so mysterious, and it was just really cool.
Her love of science started early. By 6, she declared she wanted to be an astrophysicist, her nose always in a book. Mom, Christina Sage, remembers the kindergartner catching errors.
It said in there that the sun was made of gas. She made me sit down, write the publisher, to inform him he was wrong, and we got a response. And he was like, thank you very much. Do you want to be my next editor?
To Julie, scientists are rock stars. She's met her idols, physicist and Nobel Prize winner Rainer Weiss, and renowned astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson, who pulled her on stage during one of his talks to an audience of thousands.
I stumped him because I asked a question about a brand new paper from Stephen Hawking that I read during dinner right before, and he's just like, okay.
Her question was about re-examining the black hole theory. Mind you, Julie was 11 years old. The audience was impressed, and so too was the famous scientist.
And then he actually asked to take a picture with me. So I'm like, my brain was absolutely like short-circuiting at that moment.
When she came back down to Earth, she faced the reality of middle school and classmates who often treated her like an alien.
Sure, people are going to be like, oh, you're a nerd. Okay, you're a nerd, great. I mean, being a nerd is awesome. It's not something to be ashamed of because nerds are Einstein. Nerds are Elon Musk.
Still in her tender years, this self-described science nerd has garnered national attention, appearing in a Marvel comic book and winning numerous awards. A future bright enough to rival the sun.
I feel like my purpose in life is not only to show how cool science is and share science with everyone and how important science is, but also to use science to help people.
So in between AP classes and readying herself for a shot at Harvard and MIT, she'll focus on moving her face mask from prototype to product.
Even if the pandemic ends by the time that I get this done, it's still going to protect thousands of people from other possible diseases. It can be used in doctor offices, it can be used in zoos, in construction sites, meat packing, coal mines, everything like that.
She is such an amazing young lady. I am so proud of her. I can't wait to see where she goes.
No doubt, to the moon and back.
So, who knows? Maybe in the next few decades, we'll be finding alien marine life on other planets.